Hi mga coordinates, it's me, Sarigong, and welcome to my channel. For today's video, it is requested by a student named Lee Jacob Benson, an incoming grade 3 student. The topic that he wants me to discuss is all about the periodic table of elements and a compounds. Shout out nga po pala kay Clariza, Aldrin, and Melanie. Hi! Hi also to Sir Maki Gakang and to my ate, Haite, in Kabadbaran. Love you! Matter that made up of one kind of an atom is called an element. And what is an atom? So it is the smallest particle of an element. At present, there are 94 natural elements out of 118 known elements. So all the rest, about 24 of them are human made. If atoms are the smallest bit of an element, and if an element is made up of only one kind of atom, so we conclude that there are 118 different kinds of atom. We know that atoms are made up of positively charged protons, negatively charged electrons, and neutrons that have no charge. Every element has a different atomic number, and the atomic number of the element is the number of protons in its nucleus. Look at the picture. So the hydrogen has one proton and the nitrogen has 7 protons. So therefore, the atomic number of the hydrogen is 1 and the atomic number of the nitrogen is 7. Now it's your turn. How is the atomic number of an element related to the number of protons in it? How is the periodic table organized? Third, what is the family of elements? And give one family and the members of that family. Fourth, give an example of a chemical reaction between the acid and base. Now, if you have difficulties in answering those questions, just keep on watching! A chart that organizes the elements according to similar properties are called the periodic table. Tapos sa periodic table po, makikita po natin dyan yung columns or yung mga vertical list. Ang tawag po dyan is group or family. Tapos yung naka-horizontal list naman or yung naka-rows, ang tawag po dyan is the periods. One way of grouping elements is classifying them as metals, non-metals, metalloids, and noble gases. So let us study the characteristics of each group of elements. First is metals. So most metals are hard, shiny, and solid. So they are good conductors of electricity and heat, and they reflect light. They are malleable, meaning they can be hammered or rolled into sheets. They are ductile, which means they can be drawn into wires. They tend to give up electrons easily. Metals can be divided into three kinds: the alkaline metals, the alkaline earth metals, and the transition metals. Alkaline metals are those in the group 1 of the periodic table. So they are highly active metals. They are shiny, malleable, and ductile. They are good conductor of heat and electricity. They have 1 electrons in their outer energy level. And the example of the alkaline metals are the lithium, the potassium, the cesium, and so on. The second group of the periodic table is called the alkaline earth metals. So the alkaline earth metals is similar to the alkaline metals, except that they have 2 electrons in their outer energy level. So the example of the alkaline earth metals are the beryllium, magnesium, calcium, and barium. The group 3 to 12 of the periodic table is called the transition metals. So transition metals have more valence electrons and are less reactive compared to the first two metal groups. Transition metals are shiny, many are silver in color, and they tend to be very hard with high melting and boiling point. So all transition metals except for the mercury are solid in room temperature. Transition metals includes the elements that are placed below the periodic table. Those that follow lanthanum are called lanthanides. They are all shiny, relatively reactive metals, and those that follow actinium are called actinides. They are all radioactive metals. This means that they are unstable. They break down into different, more stable elements. Group 13 to 16 each contain one or more metalloids. Group 13 of the periodic table is called the boron group. The only metalloid of this group is boron. The outer four elements are metals. All group 13 elements have 3 valence electrons and are fairly reactive. All are solids at room temperature. Group 14 is called the carbon group. Carbon is a non-metal. The next two elements are metalloids, and the final two are metals. All the elements in the carbon group have 4 valence electrons. They are not reactive. All solids at room temperature. 15 is called the nitrogen group. The first two elements in the group are non-metals. These are followed by 2 metalloids and 1 metal. All the elements in the nitrogen group have 5 valence electrons. They are vary in their reactivity. Group 16 is called the oxygen group. The first 3 elements in this group are non-metals. They are followed by 1 metalloid and 1 metal. All the elements in the oxygen group have 6 valence electrons and all are reactive. Oxygen, for example, readily reacts with metals to form compounds such as rust. Oxygen is a gas at room temperature. And other 4 elements in the group 16 are solid. Elements in group 17 are called halogens. They are highly reactive non-metals with 7 valence electrons. The halogens react violently with alkali metals, which have 1 valence electron. 2 elements combine to form a salt. For example, the halogen chlorine and the alkali metal sodium react to form table salt or a sodium chloride. The halogen groups include the gases, liquid, and solids. So for example, the chlorine is a gas at room temperature, the bromine is liquid, and the iodine is a solid. The last group or family of the periodic table is called the noble gases. So these are the elements that do not combine readily with to the other elements. So example here are the helium, the neon, and the argon. Helium is used for filling balloons and make them fly. Neon is used to the lighted sign. Argon is used in the light bulb and the laser. So we are done in the elements of the periodic table. Now let's proceed to the compounds. Compounds are substances formed when 2 or more elements combine chemically. Smallest unit of a compound is called a molecule. A molecule is a particle that is formed by sharing an electron. The force that holds the atom in the molecule together is called the chemical bond. All the examples of molecules are water molecules, the carbon dioxide, the sulfur dioxide, and the ammonia. Compounds are grouped according to a certain properties. So one way of grouping them is whether they are acids or bases. So pag-usapan natin ngayon ang acids. So an acid is a compound that turns the blue litmus paper into red. Strong acids are ang ingay ng uso. Strong acids are poisonous and can be borne in your skin. Examples of the acids are the following: the hydrochloric acid, the nitric acid, and the sulfuric acid. Some food with acid. Example, there are the oranges, lemons, the guavas, the vinegar, the strawberries, and the yogurt. Pag-usapan naman natin ngayon ang base. A base is a compound that turn the red litmus paper into blue. Bases have a bitter taste and feel slippery. Strong bases are poisonous and can be burned in your skin. Bases are also called as hydroxide or alkalis. Examples of bases are sodium hydroxide, aluminum hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide. Some household materials with bases are the salt, the baking soda, the drain cleaners, and the milk of magnesia. To test whether the solution is an acid or a base, an indicator is used. An indicator is a dye which changes the color when it mixed with the acid or a base. To describe how much acid or base is contained in a substance, scientists use the pH scale. A pH of 7 means that a substance is neutral. It is neither an acid nor a base. An acid has a pH lower than 7 and a base has a pH higher than 7. At yun po ang the periodic table of elements and a compound. So, I hope that you've learned a lot on this video. And if you like this video, please don't forget to click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell for the updates. Goodbye mga coordinates and see you sa ating next vlog.